Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Elaine Breslin. I am a certified financial planner working with Irish Life for the last 16 years. And firstly, I would like to welcome you to our webinar today. I just want to highlight that the purpose of our webinar today is really to simplify pensions for you. In terms of myself, I give advice on all elements of financial planning. So myself and Ronan are really, really comfortable in this space. So we hope you enjoy the webinar and I'll pass you across to Ronan.
That's super. Thanks a million, Elaine. Good afternoon, everybody. Ronan O'Halloran is my name. As Elaine said, look, I'm working in Irish Life for the last 15 years. And my day-to-day role, I work in the advisory arm of Irish Life, talking to people about pensions, investments, ways of protecting income, all these areas. I suppose pensions have become really, really important for all of us. So if you're here, I suppose there might be different messages for different people. You might be in your 20s now thinking about, like, I need to start a pension. You could be 45 like me thinking, oh God, I really need to get a pension. I haven't had one so far. So different messages for different people on the call. The talk's going to take about 35 to 40 minutes. We'll have some questions towards the end of the talk as well. You can send us questions in the meantime through the chat. If you're on a mobile, you can tap your screen. There's a speech bubble at the top of your screen there. You can send them questions straight through to us. Also, I'm conscious that there might be questions that are of a personal financial nature. You might not feel comfortable sharing with a group. In that situation, we'll put a link in the chat here and we'll put a QR code later on that you can click on to speak directly to one of our team if you do have questions that are of a personal financial nature. So I suppose, look, to get started, these are things we're going to talk about. I suppose, number one, why do we need to save for retirement? We're going to talk about what is a pension, how do they work? And we're going to talk about the different types of pension plans that are out there. There's various types. You might be bombarded with jargon out there. Like, there's so many options out there. It can be confusing. It can be very difficult to know where to start. And then we're also going to talk about, look, how do you actually start the pension? So I suppose the first part there, look, why a pension? We're all living longer. So for myself, I like to balance my finances into my short-term needs, my medium-term needs, and my long-term needs. So things like my short-term needs might be protecting my income, making sure that I've got an emergency fund built up if the car breaks down or the fridge breaks down. Things like pension planning are very squarely in the long-term needs. So I suppose, how do you prioritize? Really, with a pension, you're protecting your financial future. People, we're all living longer. Your male life expectancy is 87 now, and female life expectancy over 90. Your average 65-year-old today will live to 91. And that means that our pension provisions, our savings, our pension pots, they need to last us that bit longer for our retirement. So they could need to last 20, 25, 30 years, maybe longer. We do find as well that a lot of people continue to work after taking the retirement benefits. Some will question, is this down to affordability? Have we built up enough pensions? Have we put enough aside for our long-term retirements? Or is there been a bit of a change in people's attitude towards retirement? A lot of the time I'm speaking to clients that it seems that people's attitudes have changed, that maybe it's that no longer we hit age 60 or 65 and we hang up the spurs. A lot of people I speak to would like to maybe phase themselves into retirement. They might say, well, look, you know what I'd like to do? I might like to maybe work part-time from 60. I might access my pension fund at age 60 or 61. That'll allow me to work maybe 3 or 4 days a week into retirement. And I might then fully retire in my late 60s or maybe even 70. It'll be different options for different people. And like, I suppose, where do you start yourself? Like, I suppose, first off, what's your own picture for retirement? If you were to sit back now and think to yourself, well, I'm retiring next week. What do I want to do? What's on my list of things that I want to do? The answers there might be very different if you're in your 20s versus if you're in your 40s or 50s. If you're 25 now, you might have 40 years of work to go before you even consider retirement. So very, very hard to focus on that future you. If you're 45 like me, I suppose, life starts swinging around and you start getting very, very focused on what the next 15 or 20 years might bring. My picture for retirement is probably coming into sharper focus than it was maybe 10 years ago. Look, I suppose one of the key messages is something we'll talk about today. I think successful retirement really is equals preparation. I think having some sort of a structured plan in place is really, really important. And the old saying, a goal without a plan is just a wish. I do meet a lot of people who get to retirement and maybe life got in the way. Things like raising children, getting children financially independent, clearing off debt, things like mortgages, loans, etc. All these things can get in the way of our long-term plans. So having some sort of focus now on your pension and maybe putting a little bit of focus on it can reap huge rewards at the end of the day. So first off, what is a pension? And look, a pension can be as complex or as simple as you want. It's really just a long-term savings plan. And if we think about it in terms like that, it can probably become a bit of a simpler idea. It's a very, very tax efficient savings plan. And the idea is there to replace your income when you come to retirement. So I suppose people probably know about tax relief from pensions, or a lot of people know about tax relief from pensions. So you get income tax relief on the money going into your pension pot within certain limits. And the older you get, the more you'll be able to put into that pension pot. And Elaine will touch off that later on the actual workings under the hood of how pensions work. And when you get to retirement, there's a lump sum. Some or all of that may be tax-free to you. And then the balance of your pension fund, you're going to drip feed back to yourself in retirement to provide a replacement income for yourself. But I suppose the unsung hero is that middle section there. There's tax-free returns on any growth your pension makes over the years. So you will see rises and falls in the value of your pension pot over the years. But that tax-free growth, the old thing we did, I think, was it all we all did in primary school, of our maybe it's early secondary school, compound interest and tax-free growth. That can make an enormous difference to pensions. And really, the earlier you are, the younger you are, the earlier you start a pension, the better it's going to be. If you're 25 years of age now and you're not going to retire for 60 or for until 60, 65, your initial payments that you're building into that pension yourself could have 35, 40 years of tax-free investment growth within that pension structure. So it can be absolutely huge and really, really important to consider starting that pension as early as possible. Okay, how does a pension work? I suppose important to, I suppose, get advice, number one. I think it is quite a complex area. It's important to speak to a trusted advisor, somebody that you know, somebody that you trust to give you good advice. I think really important, first off, to decide what's affordable on a monthly basis. And that goes back to that idea of your short-term needs versus your long-term needs. So once the rent or mortgage is paid, once you've built up that emergency fund, once you've protected your income, now might be time to start thinking about, well, what can I start to put away now for my future self? Start saving, avail of the income tax relief. And there's various ways of getting income tax relief. You might have a pension paid directly through your salary. You might be making a contribution yourself. So various ways of getting that tax relief for yourself. Your employer could offer a pension. So if your employer offers a pension scheme and there could be an employer contribution for that pension scheme, now you've got two people paying into that pension for that future income for yourself, you and your employer. A lot of the time when I meet clients, sometimes they haven't availed of an employer's a contribution on a pension scheme. So sometimes people are effectively leaving money behind them on the table. Of course, revenue are there in the background as well. So with the tax relief that's available, the tax-free money that you're putting into, you're paying in, your employer's paying in, there's also that tax-free money coming back from revenue. That's topping up your pension pot too. Your money will be invested. And there's a choice of investment products. And the type of investment you choose will depend on a few different factors. I suppose it'll depend on if you're an experienced investor, are you used to investing? Is this your first time dipping your toes into investment markets? It'll depend on how close you are to needing these funds, how close you are to retirement. If you're 25, you might be able to go for maybe a more aggressive approach with your pension than somebody who's 55, for example. So I think really, really important to get good advice around this, because there are different options for different people. Elaine's going to talk a little bit around the tax relief and how it works if you're depending on what type of salary you're on. So really, really efficient way of saving for your retirement. And when we think about things like what fund to choose, I suppose timeframes for investing are really, really important. In general, the longer my investment timeframe, the more aggressive or the more risk I'll take with my pension. So my pension fund, for example, would be invested in a slightly higher risk category than my savings, which would be invested in a slightly higher risk category than my emergency funds or anything I'm going to need in the short term. So the longer that time frame, in general, the more risk you should take, and then the more growth you'd expect from that pension pot over time as well. Now, look, when we're talking about pensions, there's various sources of retirement income for ourselves. The state pension is there at the moment. We'll touch into a little bit of detail around the state pension. You'd hope that it will be preserved long term. There have been a lot of talk about changes to be made to the state pension, and we'll dip into that in a second. Occupational pensions. So you might have a company pension, maybe from your current company. You might have a company pension from a previous employment. This was really, really important to understand how you can access that, when you can access that, what the projections will look like, what will that look like in terms of replacement income for you in retirement. You might have personal pension arrangements, maybe a personal pension or a PRSA that you paid into yourself. You might have been an employee that was no company pension in your employment. You might have been self-employed by paying into your own pension. So again, really, really important to understand what the different types of pensions are, what you might have in place already, how and when they can be accessed. And then, of course, you could have other assets. There might be some personal savings. You could have built up some investments. You might have a property, for example, maybe a rental property. And all these things form the different pillars of our retirement income when we do come to retirement. So I think really, really good to take into account all these areas when you're speaking to an advisor or getting advice around your pension plan to say, well, look, I have these. How are they going to complement my pension plan? What am I going to need on a monthly basis? So talking about the state pension, as I said, a lot of talk and rumours of changes. They were looking at extending out the state pension age. At the moment, the state pension is €265 per week, approximately 13,800 per annum. It's due to increase. I think in the last budget, they talked about increasing it by €12 per week. So we'll see that change in January next year. So that's good news that the state pension is still there, still strong. It kicks in at age 66. You have to have enough social insurance contributions along the way, or stamps, I suppose, as they're traditionally known, along the way. If you're unsure if you're entitled to full state pension, I think the first port of call is going to mywelfare.ie. You'll find more details there. Your PRSI record can be found to see if you're going to be entitled to full state pension or not. But I suppose the state pension is a really, really important pillar of our retirement income. It is important to know that it is relatively limited as well. Like if you're on a €50,000 income at the moment, that it would represent a 74% drop in your income if you retire on state pension only. If you're on 40,000, it'll represent a 65% drop. 30,000 income, you're down nearly more than half of your income when you come to retirement. If you're on 20,000 a year, a third of your income has gone to retirement. So I suppose it does reinforce the need for making provisions for your future self now to really boost that up. There is an interim state pension at the moment for someone who's retired at 65. Will that last long term? It's hard to know. State pension was supposed to be pushed out to 67, then 68. That legislation might come back in the future. So again, I suppose it probably reinforces the need that if we think we might be entitled to state pension at 66, there's a chance that future finance bills and future budgets might push that out to 67, 68. So again, really, really important to give yourself backup when it comes to these things. And Elaine's going to talk about ways you can boost that retirement income in detail. So Elaine, okay, I'm going to pass it over to you. You're going to go through some of the details on the different types of pensions we have available.
Thank you, Ronan. Yeah, so I'm going to run through two main types of pensions that we primarily discuss with our clients. The first of those being the PRSA, or Personal Retirement Savings Account. So PRSAs were introduced in 2003 as a more convenient, flexible way for people to fund for their retirement. They can be used by anybody looking to increase their pension, looking to start a pension, or looking to increase their savings for retirement. So employers use them, employees use them, business owners and the self-employed. In Ireland today, all employers are obliged to facilitate a PRSA through payroll, but they are not obliged to make a contribution towards this PRSA. As mentioned already, a PRSA is a long-term savings plan. It is in your own name, whereby you're deferring some of your income now for your retirement, and of course, availing of significant income tax relief and tax-free growth on any money you make within the pension. A key benefit of a PRSA is its flexibility. So with a PRSA, you can increase, decrease, stop and start at any stage. You can make regular payments into that pension, or you can also make lump sum payments. A PRSA can be facilitated through your own bank account. It can be facilitated through an employer's bank account. And say if you're working with an employer and you leave that employer, you can move a PRSA from one employer's bank account to another employer's bank account. So you've ease of transition from employer to employer. If, for example, you were an employee in an organisation and you became self-employed or set up your own business, you can then move the PRSA from your employer's bank account into your own bank account. So again, ensuring that you have one pension in place moving with you as your occupation, as your life evolves. In relation to a PRSA, you can leave a PRSA and if not access until age 75. So you can continue investing in a PRSA up until age 75. But the advantage of this as well is enabling you to, I suppose, have a staggered approach to your retirement. And Ronan touched on that a little bit earlier. In relation to PRSA, the earliest you can access is 50 if not working, 60 if working. But as Ronan touched on earlier there, the state pension is available at age 66. So ideally, you should not access any pension, whether it's PRSA or any other form of pension, before you're eligible for the state pension, or at least until you cease employment. We would also suggest you do get advice if looking at any options in around accessing early. if you did not make it to retirement, your PRSA pays out your estate and debt as well. So there's a misconception that a PRSA or a pension may die with you. That isn't the case. In the event of death, you did not make it to retirement, it does pay out your estate and to your family. The next type of pension we're going to look at is a defined company, a defined contribution scheme, or a company pension, as it may also be known as. This is a pension which is set up and provided for by your employer for employees. An employee essentially is a member of the scheme. So in a defined contribution pension scheme, the contribution tends to be set. So for example, an employer may decide to say, well, okay, we're going to give a 5% employer contribution, of which the employee must match. So the employee puts in 5, the employer puts in 5. However, an employee can also top up or increase the amount that they wish to put into this pension scheme. This is called an AVC, or an additional voluntary contribution. If an employee leaves employment, a company pension can be moved. But again, going back to the whole advice piece, when you're making any changes in relation to pensions, it's really important to get advice, whether that's from an advisor, customer service team here in Irish Life, or your broker. In terms of accessing your company pension scheme, the earliest you can access is 50, if not working with an employer, or 60 if working. But again, we strongly recommend you do not access any pensions prior to actually being in receipt of the state pension. The latest you can pay into a company pension is age 70. And the value on your funds obviously depends on how much you paid in, how much your employer has paid in, and how that fund has performed and invested over the duration of the pension being in place. So here are some good reasons to start a pension. As Ronan highlighted earlier on, you are likely to spend a quarter of your life in retirement. So we all have different plans, expectations, hopes, aspirations, and goals for our retirement. And that very much varies from person to person. But it is really important to plan and to put a plan in place to ensure that if you feel the state pension isn't sufficient for you, that you have additional income on top of that to meet your needs into retirement. In terms of setting up a pension or just getting advice in general, here at Irish Life, we have qualified financial advisors available on the phone, online, to meet at home, or in your workplace. And it is our job to ensure you have a good understanding of pensions, how they work, how they operate, to determine what type of pension is the right fit for you, to review all your options, and to ensure on doing this, we complete a full financial review, and to ensure that we can enable you to make an informed decision that is right for you when the time is right for you. A next good reason to start is the state pension. So Ronan advised earlier on, the state pension currently is approximately €13,800 per annum. If you feel you could not live off this amount, it is really important to look at an alternative to top up your income into your retirement. So again, a pension is a long-term savings plan where you're deferring some income now for your retirement and getting good tax release along the way. So it's a pension plan is a really, really important tool and a way for you to increase your income into retirement. Rona touched on this earlier, the effect of compounding and starting early, but essentially the earlier you start saving into a pension, the more time you have to pay into a pension and therefore the more time your money has to grow. Compounding is essentially the interest gaining interest on the interest over the long term. Because there is no tax on any money you make in the pension, this has a significant impact on the growth of your fund and the value of your fund over the long term and effectively when you get to retirement. The final good reason is one of the main reasons that people mostly look at pensions is the tax relief. So there is significant tax relief available on pension contributions and you cannot forgo that. And as I said, it is the main reason. And I'll give you some examples in a few moments just in terms of how the tax relief works and how it's really beneficial to everyone. So we spoke there about how starting early enhances the growth and the potential growth of your pension fund. So here's an example. So we have John on my left here. So John is age 35 years old. He starts a pension contributing €75 per month and he retires at 65. To my right, we have Connor here. Connor is 25. So he started pension funding 25 years earlier, contributing the same amount, €75 per month, and he also retires at age 65. So in this example here, we can see a significant difference between the two pots. Connor has an estimated fund there of about 161,000 and John has an estimated fund of just shy of 93,000. There's a difference here of almost 68,500. And that's significant when you do get to retirement in terms of the tax-free lump sum available, in terms of the potential income you can draw down and the options that's around that. But it really highlights, if you start early, there is more opportunity for growth, there's potential to make more money, but it is also important to look at what's affordable. If it's affordable, you know, in your 20s to start small, review, continue to review, you can make lump sums, you can increase the regular amounts you're putting in, but at the end of the day, there's more opportunity to make more money when you start early. But at the same token, it is also never too late to start. Just in terms of tax relief. So we spoke quite a bit about tax relief. So now let's have a look and see how it actually works. So in this example here, first off, we're going to look at Alex. He is earning 30,000 per annum. So he's paying 20% in tax. In this example, his employer is going to make a 4% employer contribution into the pension and Alex is going to match that. So his employer is going to put 100 euro per month into the pension. Alex is also going to put 100 euro per month into the pension, of which he is eligible to get 20% tax relief. So we can see here to my right, Alex is receiving 20% tax relief. So the actual net cost to him is 80 euro. There is 200 euro going into his pension, but the actual cost is 80 euro per month. And that can be done through your wages. In this instance, the 20 euro that was going to revenue is no longer going to revenue, it is going into his pension. So effectively, he's reducing his tax bill and increasing his pension savings. In our next example, we're going to look at the 40% taxpayer. So we have Sam here. Sam is earning an income of 60,000 per annum. Again, employer is making a 4% contribution. She is also making a 4% contribution, of which she is eligible to get 40% tax relief on that payment. So in this example here, Sam saves 80 euro on tax. So 120 euro comes out of her wages and 400 goes into the pension. So there's a significant difference there in terms of how tax relief really impacts on how much goes into your pension, how much you save on tax, and ultimately then how quickly your pension can grow at a reduced cost to yourself. This is the most important part of pension planning. So if you do have any questions, to put them into the Q&A there and we can answer them later on. Next, in terms of income tax reliefs. So we've highlighted the significant income tax that's available. However, there are limits in relation to this. So Ronan touched on earlier on in terms of, you know, depending on a person's age, you know, they may have more scope to put money into pensions or they may have less of a time frame to fund for retirement. So if a person is under 30, the max that they can put into a pension personally is 15% of salary. That is capped at 115,000. Now, this increases the older you get to enable you to have more scope, to put more money in, to build and enhance your pension later in life. And to give an example there, we see a person in their 60s, we'll say, the max they can do is 40% of salary, capped at 115,000. Now, I must stress, this is the same for both an employer company pension scheme and the PRSA. So an employer can also make a contribution above this into both an employer company pension scheme or an employer funded PRSA. So this is the personal limits, but an employer can make a contribution on top of this. In terms of saving extra. So often people kind of wonder, well, you know, I've got a lump sum I've come across, you know, I've got an increase in wages, I've got a bonus, recently, I've got a pay increase, you know, what can I do with this and how can I use this money more effectively and make it work harder for you? If you have a PRSA with Irish Life and you wish to increase, you can contact your customer service team, you can contact your advisor, or of course, contact your employer should you wish to increase your monthly payments. If you have a defined contribution scheme, you contact your payroll person and just advise what percentage it is that you wish to increase by, and that will be paid across into your company pension scheme as an AVC, that additional voluntary contribution on top of the set amount you're obliged to contribute within that scheme. Very topical at the moment, we have lots of people making lump sum payments into pensions. So you can make a lump sum payment in, as I touched on a moment ago, in relation to if you got a bonus, you can make a lump sum payment in that given year, or if you got a commission payment, or we often have people making lump sum payments in against their 2022 tax bill. So, for example, October 31st has just passed. So we have numerous business owners, PAYE employees and self-employed individuals doing their tax returns. And you can make a lump sum payment into a pension against your 2022 tax bill. So this is a really important tool for to enable people to enhance their pension and also to avail of tax relief they did not avail of the year gone past. So I'll pass you back to Ronan here, and he's going to give you a bit more detail in terms of how to actually start a pension.
That's super. Thanks a million, Elaine, for that. I suppose like there is a lot to a pension. Like they can be quite complex, and there is a big change in pensions in the country to maybe simplify things. But I think it's really, really important to get good advice. So where do you start? It's actually quite a simple process once you're getting the right advice. We have a team of specialists that are available to talk to you on a one-to-one basis, or you can consult your financial broker if you have a broker as well. And what we'll do is we'll sit down with you. We can do it through Microsoft Teams. We can give you advice to say, okay, well, look, what's affordable in the short term? How much could you save each month? What type of fund should we be looking at? Are you new to investing? Are you an experienced investor? And what's the best option for you? Is it the idea of the PRSA, that personal pension arrangement? Is it the company structure? Does your employer provide a pension scheme? Are you availing of that employer's contribution? So I think really, really important to get good advice around this. And as I say, look, it can be simplified. Things like tax relief can be done at source through your payroll. You can go onto your revenue online system to claim your tax back if you need to. And I suppose it's important to understand that, advice just doesn't come at the start of a pension and setting up a pension. It's really important to be stay updated along the way, as it is as well. Myself and Elaine would often complete regular reviews with our clients. We'd sit down maybe once every 6 months or once a year to have a look at the pension, see what's changed with your own finances, see where we're going over the next 12 months, and see if we're invested appropriately for you now. So really, really important to get that good advice. So how can we help? You can book a complimentary chat with one of our financial advisors. You can click on the QR code and book in with one of our team in a confidential manner. We also have a chat or a link in the chat there that you can click on again to speak to one of the team if you have any questions. And look, a lot of the time people think that they need to have a lot of money or at least have a lot of experience to speak to a financial advisor. That isn't the case at all. We're here to help in all circumstances, whether you're inexperienced and getting close to retirement at this stage and you need to build up that pension fund, or if you're just starting off on the road of employment and need to get your first pension set up, we're here for everybody. So look, there's quite a lot of information there. I hope it was helpful. We're going to open up to any questions you have. So if you do have any questions, you can pop them into the chat there. The QR code is available as well if you would like to book in an appointment directly with one of our advisors. And I see there's a couple of questions coming through at the moment. I'll read out the first one there. So, and then there's one there saying, look, hi there, I have pensions from two previous employments, but wasn't in either one of them for long. You've been advised to get advice on whether to keep the funds in a PRB for one of them, or if I should move it into one of my Irish Life employee pension. I suppose, look, for situations like that, there's probably no one size fits all when it comes to pensions. I think that'd be really, really good to discuss on an individual basis with an advisor. Pensions can be quite complex, especially when it comes to retirement and your retirement options. If you're to combine them all into one plan, you might be shutting a door for maybe drawing them at separate times in retirement, for example. So I think in that situation, definitely speak to one of the team on a one-to-one basis, and they'll be able to give you a good guideline of how to proceed from there. There's another one, Elaine, there just saying, yeah. You mentioned that a PRSA pays out in the event of your death. How does this work? Is it as a lump sum into your estate?
Yeah, just on that. So in terms of a PRSA on death, yes, it does indeed. It pays out as a lump sum to your estate. So it's separate to anything else that you have. But again, this highlights just in terms of if you have pensions from previous employments, if you have a PRSA with a various organizations or from various employers, just to, that you know where they are. Because if you don't know where they are, something happened to you, you didn't make it to retirement, how is a family member, friend meant to know where they are? So it's just really, really important to link in with an advisor, ensure you know exactly what type of pensions you have and where they are. But absolutely, in the event of death, PRSA pays out as a lump sum to your estate.
Super. Thanks for that, Elaine. Another question here around defined benefit pensions. So saying, look, I have a defined benefit pension from a previous employer. Should I move this to a PRSA? And again, that's quite a complex one. That's a difficult question to answer on a one-to-one basis. There'd be a lot of things to take into account, I suppose. Is your defined benefit pension scheme winding up, for example? What's your state of health? What other pension benefits do you have? And again, I think that's probably one that should be dealt with on a one-to-one basis with an advisor, because there's a lot of factors that would guide advice when it comes into whether one pension type should be transferred into another or not. Elaine, there's another one there on private pensions.
Yep, I can see that one there. So I have a private pension and wondered after the lump sum is drawn down, at what rate will I be taxed on the remaining balance? Again, Ronan touched on with the last question, it's really, really important to get advice. We can't kind of give any specifics on individual cases because the level of or the potential tax that may be paid on drawdown will depend on additional income streams when you draw down or the pensions that you may have, you know, if you're in receipt of the state pension. So there are lots of factors at play in order to determine, you know, if or when tax would be payable on an income from a pension. So again, link in with Rowan and myself with our advisors, and we can give you a steer on that.
Super. Thanks, Elaine. And another question coming in there, just asking, what's the difference between a PRSA and PRSI? Well, they're actually quite different. A PRSA is a personal retirement savings account. So a PRSA is a type of personal pension. So personal retirement savings account. PRSI is pay-related social insurance. So PRSI is a type of tax that you pay. So almost complete opposite ends of the scale. PRSI is something that you're paying out in tax. PRSA is something that you're paying into to save your income tax. So I suppose that's the difference between the two of those. And does anybody have any other questions there? Super. Look, there don't seem to be many more questions coming in. As I said, look, there might be questions that are of a personal nature you prefer to deal with on a one-to-one basis as opposed to sharing it on a forum. So you can click on the QR code and speak directly to one of our financial advisors within Irish Life, and they'll be able to give you any guidance you need, whether that's on your existing pensions, on setting up a new pension, or even what your retirement options are. We'll also send out a link as well after the webinar that you'll be able to access the details on the slides and hear us talk again. So look, I'm conscious it's lunchtime. I'm hoping we've kept into our 35 minutes. I hope it's beneficial for everybody. I'd like to thank you all for attending. Elaine, thanks a million for your input today. It's invaluable around the workings of the pensions. And thanks everybody for your time today.
Thank you.
Take care. Bye.